Hello everyone, good morning. I am Ash and I'm here with the Volvo XC40 Recharge Twin. They're a full electric crossover and I have this because I've been working with Plug and Drive, a nonprofit organization that does pop-up events for EV education. We have been doing the meet, the mobile EV education trailer in and around Alberta for the past month or so. We've done Banff and Canmore and Edmonton. It's been a great time. They brought us up this car from their Toronto headquarters so that we can let people take them for ride and drives and experience driving a full electric vehicle. And now that it's over, they need it back in Toronto. So we're going to bring it back to them. I've never done a cross Canada road trip in an EV before, so this is going to be an interesting experience for me. So I thought I would vlog it and let you guys come along and see how it goes. So we are fully charged. First leg of the journey is going to be from here in Calgary to Regina. And yeah, I guess we're ready to head out. Let's go. All right, we got it on the Flow fast charger here. Solid 50 kilowatts, as is to be expected with the very always solid Flow chargers. And yeah, now time to grab something to eat. Probably go in the mall and see what I can find. Can't remember life before you. Ups, down the ceilings, on the floor. Kill me slow with every kiss. Consider this my dying wish tonight. All right, we are at our second charging stop. We're in Swift Current at the Co-op gas bar, and I ran into my first charging hiccup. I went to the station over there. There's two stations here, and that one started off just fine. It gave me 100 kilowatts right off the bat, and after about a minute or so, it would just quit. About 1 kilowatt hour worth delivered, and it would just, for no reason, just stop. It wouldn't give an error code or anything on the screen. It just says please unplug, as if I had hit the stop manually. So I don't know what happened there, but I came over to this other one and this one's giving me a bit less, only around 80 kilowatts, but at least it's working. So no problem there. I was gonna run into the washroom, but the gas bar is closed. So anyways, charging is moving right along quite at a decent pace, and we're gonna have to head out pretty soon here. So we're gonna go on to our next charging station at the Moose Jaw Canadian Tire. I have to head into Canadian Tire anyways to grab a few things, so that'll be the next stop on our list. Well, let's go. We are now at the Flow chargers in Moose Jaw at the Canadian Tire. There's two of them, which is quite lovely. There is this sweet lightning here that evidently actually gets used. Well, good on them. And we are pulling a solid 49 kilowatts, just as with always with these all. Really reliable, slow, but very reliable chargers. Anyways, gonna run into Canadian Tire. Got a few things to return, a few things to grab, and then we'll be right back to head out to Regina. Alright, we are here in the hotel room in Regina, and I chose this hotel specifically because they offer level 2 EV charging, although the chargers are evidently very old and pretty crusty. The Sun Country unit outside took about a dozen tries for me to get it going because it would just click on and then click right back off again, so clearly there's something wrong going on with the handshake, and I figured out that if you hold the plug at an angle, pressured towards the left, then it would engage, and once it engaged, it works just fine. So it works questionably. I don't really consider that to be acceptable per se, but whatever. It's working fine now. It's charging out there at 11 kilowatts, and so I think it is time to call it a wrap for the first day of the trip, and we'll be back on the road in the morning. Good night. Good morning. Time to set off on day 2 of our trip. Car is charged up and ready to go. We're going to be heading east to Winnipeg and then heading down south towards the States to go south of the Great Lakes, because last time I drove back from Montreal, I took the northern route above them, and so I thought I'd try out the southern route this time. So it's going to be a whole another day of probably just a lot of nothing because the prairies are very boring. So I'm probably going to try and keep it quick and just condense it all, and then once we actually get past all that into the more things to see, and then we'll show more of that. Alrighty, off we go. Look at that, 127, 128 kilowatts on our first charging stop at Petro-Canada in Whitewood. It's actually the fastest charging that I've gotten out of Petro-Canada so far on the trip. Our consumption so far today, 215 watt-hour per kilometer. We ended the day yesterday with 208, so remaining fairly consistent, although, again, it's driving kind of slow and trying to tuck in whenever I can. I might try to start just driving normally solo to see what it does, but anyways, going to head in for a drink or something, and then we're going to come back and we're going to play around in the back of the car for a bit if we got some extra time. I have to charge here for a little bit long because according to PlugShare, the next charger that's suggested to be used on the route, which is this Valley View Co-op here, is kind of sketchy and may or may not work. And this is what generally what I do when I sit to charge or I got a bit of spare time, is spend a few minutes, check out the next charging stop that's suggested by either the car or a better route planner using PlugShare, which of course shows all the chargers there, very good app, and see what's going on. If the chargers show as available, it doesn't even show as available with Co-op, which is kind of annoying. Petro and Flo do show their status, but just check the reviews and see what people got going on, and evidently the past few were kind of bad, so I'm gonna stop here anyways to try it, probably. We'll see how it goes, actually. But at least, according to the past few reviews, it's not worth actually betting on this one. So we're gonna sit here for a bit longer to have enough charge to bypass this one, and then go right on to Brandon, Manitoba for lunch. Alright, I didn't want to do the voiceover back there live because both the dispenser for the charger and the transformer running it are absolutely wailing. I didn't want to talk over it. But anyways, I've been spending some time back there blowing up these little air mattress thingies and dicking around with it and getting it going so that we can have a bed set up back there, because my plan for at least the next night, probably two, is to just sleep in the back of the car while on a level 2 charger. I've never been car camping before, so I just wanted to see what it was like, and I guess this is a decent opportunity to try it. So we'll see how that works out. It seems that I fit back there pretty well. I have enough room to lay straight, at least diagonally, with being able to close the trunk, so yeah, it shouldn't be too much of a problem fitment-wise. But anyways, we just hit 80%, so we should have more than enough to get to Brandon without having to stop at the aforementioned station, so let's get going. Alright, we are here at the Shell Recharge just off the Trans-Canada Highway in Brandon, Manitoba. It's two stations here that for some reason say that they do 180 kilowatts. And I had a hard time believing that because to my knowledge these stations only do around 50. So I was expecting to get around 50 and actually getting 59. So compared to what I was expecting, actually pretty pleasant surprise. Well, anyways, I'm gonna go for lunch just at the A&W on the other side of this gas station here, and then I will be right back and ready to hit the road again. I'm on my last lifeline. Yeah, but if you do, it's gonna take a little time, but I'll be fine. It's a fix I'm needing, and I got to have it. Far from the 100 kilowatts that it's advertised to deliver, but at least it is working. We don't need a whole lot here, so I'm just gonna run in for a pee break and grab another drink, and then we will be back on our way down south towards North Dakota? I think North Dakota. America. Towards America. That's the one. And shout out to Co-op and Petro charging stations for actually having garbage cans and windshield cleaners, because look at this absolute mess over here. Oh, I gotta clean this up, and then we will head out. But if you do, don't say this was a waste of time, because tonight, it's a fix I'm needing, and I got to have it. Welcome to my lair. We are in the city of Grand Forks in North Dakota, and we are just gonna stop by here for the night. We're parked up at a level 2 charger at the perfect place, right by a truck stop with about a dozen truckers over there that are also just sleeping away in their cab, so it's an excellent spot for us.
and I went out and grabbed dinner at this awesome Japanese restaurant just down the road called Sakura. It was really, really delicious and an amazingly decorated place. But anyways, yeah, I think it's time to wrap up for the night. As you can see, I'm already in my bed gear and everything, so yeah, it's been a long day, a lot of driving, and so back at it in the morning. Good night, guys. Good morning. That was a surprisingly good night. Yeah, I actually slept a lot better than I thought I would. Yeah, I would do that again. So yeah, it's promising for the next few nights at least. Some numbers from yesterday, 803 kilometers we drove, and we averaged 235 watt-hour per kilometer. That was with just speed limit or slightly above driving, no special techniques or anything, so it's not too bad. Not too far off from what we were getting before we were actually trying to do really well for consumption. So, yeah, it's time for another day of just driving, so we'll rapid fire through it, heading toward the Minneapolis-St. Paul area. Let's go.
Plans and how involved in them I am. So stay right where we were last time we met, 'cause I can't lose this again. Wish I had a map with an X on it. Wish I had a map with an X on it.
We are now at the Twin Cities in Minneapolis, St. Paul, just at an Electrify America on the east side of town at a Walmart, topping up here. And I spent a bit of time hanging around the city and taking a look at things. And I watch this YouTuber a lot. This is not compute. The guy, Colin, who runs the channel, is actually local to here. And I didn't get to meet him or anything like that, but he does a lot of retro tech and computers and things like that on his channel. So that's what you like. I highly suggest checking him out and seeing if you like it too. But his channel talk, he has a couple videos where he talks about this place called Free Geeks Twin Cities. And they're a nonprofit organization in Minneapolis that does e-waste recycling and salvages retro tech and puts them up to be available for sale to people at their thrift store. And so I stopped by just to check it out and see what they have. And yeah, it is a really, really neat place in there. They have their floor of tons and tons of retro PCs, old accessories, you know, boxes of ISA cards and DDR1 RAM and things like that, a whole shelf full of home theater receivers and more modern PCs as well. Part of what they do is have affordable, more modern laptops and desktops that are not crazy, but things that are capable enough to get basic work done for students and low-income families who need a PC. And volunteers can go in there and learn how to disassemble and work with PCs and, you know, help them out. And after a certain amount of time of volunteering, they can even take one home if that is something that they need. Or and they have low-income programs, things like that as well. So that I think it's really awesome what they do. And it was really cool to be able to... I saw it, of course, on his videos and the documentary that he made. And it was really cool to see the place in person. And there were a lot of incredibly friendly people in there. They gave me a tour around back too. I didn't take a whole lot of footage of back there, and it's kind of their private area, so I won't post a whole lot of it. But it was really awesome experience, and it was really cool to be able to see it. But anyways, we have more than what we need now. I had to actually run into Walmart and grab some nail clippers because these are getting kind of long, and I didn't bring one with me. But yeah, it's time to head out east of the city towards Eau Claire. It's 4:38 now, so we're gonna just head out there and grab dinner. We're gonna be there along the way, and yeah, we'll see how it goes. We've only been getting about 90 something kilowatts when we first started, and then dropped to around 80 at around halfway, which is less than what I usually get. So I don't know if it's rapid gating or what's going on here, but anyways, we got enough. Let's head out.
Baby, you're gold, gold. First place in my heart. I've been so close.
Alright, so stationed up at another level 2, getting ready to spend the night. Today's drive, 740.8 kilometers, average 233 watt hour per kilometer, which is not too bad.
Honestly, could have done a bit more driving. It's only 8 o'clock, but for me, feeling pretty tired. It's been a long day, and I just want to go to bed, so I think I'm going to go do that. Of course, this whole car camping thing, as a reminder, is completely voluntary on my behalf. You don't actually have to sleep in your car to be able to do this same trip in an EV. There are hotels around, and a good amount of them have free level 2 charging. Medium city or larger, you'll find at least one hotel that has free level 2 charging. Just hit a plug share to wherever your destination is, and surely it will pop up on there. As for me, gotta get ready for bed. Maybe get an early start if I get up early in the morning tomorrow, and then we will hit the road headed east towards Milwaukee. We'll see you in the morning.
I can't read you. I've given everything, but you seem distant. I can't feel you. Your heart is somewhere else, it's missing. What if I breathe back to you? Wish I had a map with an X on it. Wish I had a map with an X on it. Baby, you're gold, gold. First place in my heart. I've been so cold, cold. Can we go back to the start?
Good morning. After yesterday's drive, which averaged 231 watt hour per kilometer, which is quite good, and staying a nice night at this brand new hotel in Grand Rapids, Michigan, like literally a month old. It's actually really nice. It is time to head back towards the Canadian border and head on to London, Ontario. Let's go.
I never sleep, but with you, I can get some rest. Well, I got demons on the side of my bed. I close my eyes and they get in my head. So stay with me, my remedy. I never sleep, but with you, I can get some rest. Way away, I waste away the rest of me, the best of me. So patiently, I came to see the side of me. It only bleeds. Yeah, they wanna come and play. They can always get their way. You can be my heart away. You can take the knife away. I know they my inner self. Grab my bed and hold my breath. Tell me there ain't nothing left. Shadows on the shelf. And the ones that love me the most are the ones that up and ghost. And I got a feeling I'm the reason that they go. In my stomach I feel that pit. Toughen up but I'm scared of shit. And when I lay my head it shows. Well, I got demons on the side of my bed. I close my eyes and they
my head. So stay with me, my remedy. I never sleep, but with you I can get some rest. Well, I got demons on the side of my bed. I close my eyes and they get in my head. So stay with me, my remedy. I never sleep, but with you I can get some rest.
And that wraps it up. So 5 days, almost 4,000 kilometers, 13 charging stops, and we averaged 233 watt hour per kilometer, which my friend Emil, a Tesla owner behind the camera right now, probably finds pretty egregious, but that's just what it is for this car. I actually did pretty decent for this car. But yeah, it is time to say goodbye to it. I am probably gonna miss it, but thank you to Plug and Drive for this awesome opportunity to get to drive out here, see Toronto, see my friend again, and get to deliver this car and see all the sights along the way. And proving that it is possible to take a, for today's standards, not that great range of an EV on a road trip across the country. Well, thank you very much for watching. Take care. See you next time.